Dear students, there will be a question. Neomethyl chloride undergo elimination reaction, that is E2 elimination, readily than methyl chloride. Why? How can we answer this question? You should know, first of all, you should know what is a methyl chloride and neomethyl chloride. Actually, this methyl chloride and neomethyl chlorides are diastereomers. Therefore, both have the same structural formula. The structural formula you can draw just like this way. There will be a cyclohexane ring is there, and here it is a isopropyl group is there. That is, here CH is the CH3 isopropyl group, and in next position you can see there is a chlorine. That is first position an isopropyl group, second position you can see a chlorine atom, and in third and fourth position you have a methyl group. This is the structural formula of both methyl chloride and isomethyl neomethyl chloride. Now if you go to this diastereomic form, you can see that in neomethyl chloride you can see there is a carbon is the and CH3 you can see in this way, and there is a chlorine is the, and here there is CH3 group. What is the point is that this isopropyl group and this chlorine atom is on the same side of the ring. That means they have a cis arrangement. But this CH3 group is on the other side. That means this group and this group have trans way of arrangement. That you can see when I am drawing the chair form of this cyclohexane ring. This is neomethyl chloride. And when you go to the methyl chloride, you can see that here again there is a C, now CH3. Here there is chlorine drawing like this way, and methyl group like this way. You can see that this group and this group are on the same side, whereas chlorine is on the other side. That is, we call it as a methyl chloride. Now we have to consider the chair form of this one and this one, and which will undergo the elimination reaction more readily. Okay, let's start from neomethyl chloride. In neomethyl chloride you can see there is a cyclohexane ring, then a isopropyl group is there, and chlorine, then CH3. This isopropyl and chlorine are on the same side of the plane. That means they have a cis arrangement, whereas this chlorine and CH3 group should be in opposite direction. Moreover, this one and this one is also again in opposite direction. They are in trans arrangement. In cyclohexane there is chair form, bond form, etc., but only the chair form have the existence. So I am drawing here the chair form of cyclohexane just like this way. You know, in chair form there are two position. One is we call it as axial position, next one is we call it as equatorial position. If you are drawing the first axial position like this way, the adjacent carbon should have an axial position in this way. That means this one and this one in opposite direction, one towards upwards and next one is downwards. Then this should be upwards, this should be downwards, this should be upwards, this should be downwards. Similarly, there is equatorial position too. The equatorial position I am drawing one towards this direction. If I am drawing the first equatorial position in this direction, that is towards this direction, then this should be in the opposite direction, that is just opposite to this one, this way. Then here I am drawing that is just like this way. This is towards this direction, this should be opposite of that one. This should be like this, and next one this would be like this, and next one this would be like this. This is the way of drawing the equatorial position. You know, adhaayathu randum opposite direction le nammal varakkan padallu. If so, then here there is an isopropyl group. So on drawing the structure of isopropyl, that can be either at axial position or equatorial positions. But if you are drawing this isopropyl group at axial position, you can say that in axial position there is a possibility of 1,3 interaction. 1,3 interaction may be due to methyl group, ethyl group, isopropyl group, etc. If the group is very bulkier, just like isopropyl, tertiary butyl, etc., this 1-3 interaction will be very much high. The molecule is highly strained. That means the existence of that molecule, you cannot say that there is an existence of that molecule. That other molecules exist cheyilla. Therefore, if there is an isopropyl group, you can draw the structure in which the isopropyl group is present at only at equatorial position. So, on drawing the structure of neomethyl chloride, you should start from this position. Here there is axial position and equatorial position. I am going to draw this isopropyl group. I told you that isopropyl group should be present at equatorial position. Therefore, the isopropyl group, I am drawing CH3 like this one. Now next, I want to draw this chlorine. One of the point is that this isopropyl and this chlorine is on the same side of a plane. That means the chlorine have to draw, if you take it as number 1 position, if you take it as number 2 position, the chlorine have to draw either at here or here. If I am drawing chlorine here, you can see that if you consider this plane, this isopropyl is on this part of the plane, chlorine is on the other part of the plane. That means this one and this one have trans arrangement. But if I am drawing the chlorine like this way, if I am drawing here, you can see that this chlorine and this isopropyl group is on the same side of the plane. That means they are in cis arrangement. That is the requirement we need here, right? Now we goes to, that is, it is taken as number 1 position, it is number 2 position, number 3 position, number 4 position. We have to go to number 2, number 3 is there and number 4 is there. You can see that the chlorine atom and CH3 group are in trans arrangement. That should be in opposite plane. That means if you consider this is the plane now, if you consider this is the plane now, the chlorine is on this side, definitely the CH3 group should be the other side of the plane. That means if you are drawing a CH3 group here, you can see that this chlorine and this CH3 is on the same side. That should be the that should not be the structure of the neomethyl chloride. Therefore, the CH3 group should be here. CH3 group should be here. Here you can say that it is one of the stablest form of methyl chloride molecule. It is because here isopropyl group and CH3 group both are in at equatorial position, and there is a less probability of 1-3 interaction. Therefore, this molecule is highly stable. We have to consider its elimination reaction. Okay, now let us consider the elimination reaction. That means the elimination of HCl molecules from neomethyl chloride. This is the structure of neomethyl chloride. This on reaction with the NaOC2H5, that is sodium ethoxide, an HCl molecule should be removed from here. That should follow the E2 mechanism also. You know, what is the condition for an E2 mechanism? That the eliminating group should be have an anti-periplanar arrangement. The anti-periplanar arrangement is nothing but the eliminating group should be on the same plane. That's the first condition. And they should be in opposite direction too. Consider these molecules. You can see that the chlorine is there. The chlorine is at axial position, you know, in these molecules. Therefore, the H atom more have to be removed from these molecules. That H atom should be at axial position also. Moreover, that should be in opposite direction also. You can say that here there is isopropyl group, but here there is hydrogen is there. Now here there is hydrogen is there, here again hydrogen is there. You can say that this hydrogen atom and this chlorine atom are present on the adjacent position. They are both are in axial arrangements and both are in opposite direction. Therefore, there is a possibility that this HCl will be removed from here, just like this way. HCl will be removed from here and a double bond is formed. Due to this, you will get a structure just like this way. A double bond is there and here there is CH3 is there. And next one, here there is isopropyl group. And there is one of the possibilities, this one. There is one more possibility is that, you can see that this chlorine and this hydrogen, they are again on the adjacent positions and they are in opposite direction. Moreover, both are in axial position also. That is, this H and this chlorine also satisfy the condition for anti-periplanarity. Therefore, there is another possibility is that there is this type of removal of HCl is also the due to that you will get a different product, like here there is CH3 group, double bond will be created here, okay, then here there is CH3, you will get this product also. That is this product and this product, there are possibility of two products. Now we have to name it, what is to be known as. This is actually the methene. One is we call it as 2-methene and next one is we call it as 3-methene. How can name it? That is, you start from here, number one. You give a number one for this CH3 group. So the things will be very easily. This is 1%, this is 2%, this is 3%, and this is 4%. So you can say that the double bond is present at the 2%. Therefore, it is known as a 1-methene. It is actually, it's a common name. It is a common name, not IUPAC name. It is known as 2-methene. 2-methene. If you consider this molecule, 1, 2, 3, you can see that double bond is present at 3%. It is a 3-methene. 3-methene. Therefore, we can say that neomethyl chloride easily undergo elimination reaction because it satisfy, it fulfill the requirement of antiplanarity, and there is a possibility of 2-methene and 3-methene very easily, two products will be formed. Out of this, you can see that this is more substituted alkene because here there is isopropyl group, here it is H and this one. But here, such type of group is not present on this double bond. You can say that according to Seitz's rule, the more substituted alkene is always the major product. Therefore, this is more substituted than this one. Therefore, this is taken as major product. This is taken as what? Minor product. That means neomethyl chloride undergo elimination very easily to form 3-methene and 2-methene. Out of this, 3-methene is major product. Now, we have to consider what happened in the case of methyl chloride. Okay, look what happened in the case of methyl chloride. You can see that isopropyl group and chlorine both should be in opposite side of the plane. That means they are have trans arrangement. This should be at this one and this one should be at cis arrangement, but they should be at trans arrangement. How can we draw it? Look at here. This is actually this chair form of this one. I told you, if there is isopropyl group, definitely that should be at equatorial position. So I am starting from here. This is actually isopropyl group, and chlorine is there. Chlorine, either you can draw on here or here. If I am drawing chlorine here, you can see that this one and this one have a cis arrangement. That is on the same side of the plane. But actually, the molecule in the case of methyl chloride, this one and this one are should be in the opposite direction, opposite side of the plane. That means chlorine is present here. Okay, now we go to that is a CH3 group. Here it is at the equatorial position, and this one and this one should be at opposite side of the plane. That means if I'm drawing methyl group here, chlorine and methyl is on the same side. That is not the required condition for this molecule. Therefore, the CH3 group should be here. That means chlorine and CH3 is on the opposite side of the plane, one towards upwards and next one towards downwards. Okay, now this molecule is relatively unstable because methyl group is there, that is at axial position. Therefore, the molecule is relatively unstable because of the presence of 1,3 interaction. Moreover, I told you that during elimination reaction, there is a requirement of anti-periplanar arrangement. In the case of cyclohexane ring, this anti-periplanar arrangement is possible only if the chlorine atom or the eliminating group is present at axial position. But here you can see that chlorine is at equatorial positions. Therefore, this molecule as such could not undergo this elimination reaction. So, in order to undergo the elimination reaction, first this molecule have to flip the ring. Ring means this chair form shall be changes to just like this way. During this process, you can see that here there is a isopropyl group. Now the chlorine will changes to that is here. That means the equatorial chlorine will becomes axial chlorine. That is the point. Now next one, here there is a CH3 group is there, that is at the axial position here. That will be, goes to that is the equatorial position. CH3 will be at equatorial position. Now what will happen, that you can see that here there is H is there, here there is H is the, and here equatorial H is the. Now HCl have to be removed. Chlorine is the H should be at the adjacent carbon atom, that should be at axial position also. But here you can see that carbon is the, H is the, but this H is at equatorial position. Therefore, this H cannot be removed. But here H is there, that is at anti-periplanar arrangement is there. Therefore, HCl will be removed. So the final product you will get just like this way. Here there is isopropyl group. A double bond is formed here. Here there is CH3 group. Now its name is that you start numbering from number 1 here, number 2, number 3, number 4. It is known as, I told you earlier, it is known as 2-methene. That means that is methyl chloride also undergo elimination reaction. The product is 2-methene, but the methyl chloride molecule does not have the requirement of anti-periplanarity. So the molecule have to flip to another chair form, where you can see that isopropyl group is at axial position. This is highly strained or highly unstable form, and this unstable form have to undergo the elimination reaction. Whereas in the neomethyl chloride, you can see that the molecule as such can undergo the elimination reaction, product is formed. But here the molecule as such could not undergo, it have to ring flip is there. So this reaction takes place less readily compared to the neomethyl chloride. Okay, this is how this is the way of answering that question. Okay.